Hi friends, welcome to First Studies YouTube channel. This is part 87 in Azure Data Factory playlist. In this video, we are going to discuss about inline dataset in Azure Data Factory. So you might have heard about this inline dataset, right? Inside the mapping data flows, these inline datasets you will see usually. So what is that inline dataset and how it is actually different from actual dataset? That is what we are going to discuss in this video. So let me go to my Azure Data Factory. So this is my Azure Data Factory ADF Mahir. Okay, so let me go to this author menu. So let me first explain you like what is dataset. Some of the people already know that, right? What is the dataset and all, but I'm giving you like quick recap. So dataset is nothing but like a pointer to your data indirectly. So that means using dataset, you are kind of creating an object which points to your data inside storage. The data may be a file or the data may be table. So dataset is a way or is a mechanism to point to that particular file or table and then use that file data or table data for your ETL purpose or for your data transformation purpose. So that is what it is, right? If you see here, let me quickly create a new dataset first here. So I am trying to create a new dataset here. So maybe I want to create a dataset for a file which is available inside my block storage. So I am selecting a block. Let me click continue. Or maybe my file is CSV format. So select this delimited text, continue. So you can give any name to it. Okay, let it be delimited text one. And here you need to select a linked service which is pointing to your block storage. I already have a linked service for that, so I selected it. If I open this linked service, it is pointing to Mahir SA. So this is the storage account to which it is pointing. Okay, now let me browse this location. So inside the storage account, actually I have a ADF demo container. If I go inside this ADF demo container, maybe if I go to this input folder, there is some file, maybe this raw data March 2018, right? So for this file, I want to create a pointer or I want to create a data set so that maybe I can use this data set in my activities or in my pipeline or in my data flows, right? To do any kind of maybe data load or data transformation, whatever it is. So this is how we usually create pointers to the data set, pointers to the data and make use of them. So data set is a mechanism of doing that. But what if the need of this particular file or need of this particular data set is only at one time in the data flow? So maybe I don't want to reuse this data set in multiple places. I just want to use it in one data flow. Maybe according to my project need, I need to create a data flow which has to consume that same file, whatever I have shown, right? So what I can do here inside the source transformation, I can select this data set, whatever we just created, right? And then if I go to data preview and if I refresh, I can see like that file data will come here. And after this, I can implement a data transformation logic and I can make sure my entire flow work goes. But think in a practical approach where this particular file, whatever the file we are pointing, right? If I go to storage account, we are actually pointing to ADF demo container, input folder and March file. So this is the file we are pointing, right? So maybe according to our project need, we just need to point to this file only at one time, right? We don't want to point to that file multiple times. In that case, if you technically think, we are ending up having a data set for it practically in the repo. And if this is only one data set, that is fine. Maybe think like I have 100 files or 100 tables for which I may need to have a pointer or a data set only one time, then you are going to end up with having 100 data sets, right? Technically speaking, but you are not actually reusing them. So to avoid these kind of situations, this inline data sets is work, these are going to work actually. So here what I am going to do for this, under this source transformation, so I know need to have a physical data set for it because I am going to use that file only once, or maybe I don't have a dependency of the schema. I don't want to. So when you practically create one data set, actually it is going to have a schema also inside it. See here, under projection you see the schema, and also if you go to the data set here under schema also you see. So data set is actually defines the schema and also actual data, actual file or actual table, right? Maybe I don't need those kind of requirement, or maybe I don't need to have that physical data set for it because I'm not going to reuse it multiple times. So in such scenarios, the best way is go with the inline data set inside the data flows. So you need to remember one thing, this inline data flows will be available only inside the data flows only. They are not available in the activities. These are like Spark based things. Okay. And see here, when I select this inline data set, automatically it will ask you like what type of inline data set it is. So here I can say like it is going to be a CSV file, right? So I will select like delimited text of inline data set. And then the moment you selected that format here or dataset type here, it will ask you, okay, what is the storage, from which storage you want to point to any file or you want to point to any delimited text file, please select the storage here. So we have already created I have already created a linked service for my blob storage load. So I am simply selecting this here. Now if you closely observe, if I go to source options, so far I just selected the dataset type and also I selected the linked service for the storage only. I haven't pointed this inline dataset to my file yet. So to do that, you need to navigate to source options. The moment you go to source option, all these options, whatever you are seeing here, these are almost equal to the options what you see inside the dataset. So if I go to this delimited text1 dataset also, see here, this compression type, column delimiter, row delimiter, everything is available under source options as well. Okay. And here, what I can do here, I can browse that location, right? So let me go to this root directory, that means root container ADF demo and input folder, and then March file. So I can select it, right? Let me do okay. So now this inline dataset is doing the same job. It is pointing to the same March file folder, same March file data, but I haven't had any dataset created under this datasets category here. That means this is inline. This is not a physical dataset which is created under your ADF. Okay. So this way you don't need to maintain much things here. Since you are not going to reuse this dataset, deciding it as a inline dataset is the actual way or the best way. So now here, if I do the data preview, still I will see the same data. Okay, without any issue, I should be able to see the data still. Great. See, data came, but if you observe, our first row also came as a data, right? And column names became like column 0, column 1, column 2. Why? Because if I go to source options, here I should mention my first row in the file should be header, right? So if I go to file, you can see my first row is actually headers, right? These are headers, and all these other rows are like actual data. So the same thing I defined under the source option now. Now if I refresh this, it should get my data properly. Great. See, we got our data properly. So the thing what we have to observe is inline data sets are little different than the physical data sets. So these physical data sets actually ending up with having a object created inside the dataset category, but inline is not that case. This is like on fly. So where you have a need, where you no need to reuse this dataset, if any such kind of scenarios are there, or if there is schema flexibility, so there is no schema, the schema can be flexible. In such scenarios, you can go with the inline datasets. If I go to projection, see here, there is no schema because this is an inline dataset. So if you create a physical dataset only, schema will come. But still, you can import the schema after defining your source options and everything. If you hit this import schema, then it is going to get the schema also to you. So let me hit this import button and let me see if I get the schema here properly or not. Great. See, schema came like this. But there is no physical dataset entity created under the dataset category. So this is the main difference what you have to observe. So let me go to the presentation. So that is what I defined. So inline dataset allows you to access the data from the resources without creating a physical dataset. So that is what I said, right? And second thing, if your operation does not need to have a schema, or you don't need to have a physical dataset to reuse in multiple places, in that cases, inline dataset will be a good option. So this is what my observation about this inline datasets. Hope you guys got a idea about what inline dataset is. Thank you for watching this video. Please subscribe to my channel and press the bell icon to get the notification whenever I add videos. Thank you so much.